Hello, my name is Travis Coan. I'm a lecturer in quantitative politics in the Department of Politics and the Exeter Keystep Center. And I'm here today to talk to you briefly about a course that I'll be offering on our new MSc in Policy Analytics. The course is called Text as Data, and we'll get right into what that means and what that means for you. So before we get going on Text as Data, we'll talk just a bit about what is meant by policy analytics and how do we see policy analytics. And so we really see this as data-driven decision-making, okay? And so data is sort of a critical part in many processes, both within industry and within government. And so what we're hoping is we'll give you the set of tools to harness and use that data to make informed policy decisions. Without data, we get into, I love this quote, if we have data, let's look at it. If all we have are opinions, let's go with mine. And we want to hope that we make informed choices and not rely simply on opinion. So that's what we're trying to do. So what skills do you need? I talked a little bit about the skills that are essential. And these skills generally fit within kind of this broad theme of what I think typically has been called data science now. But it's really pulling on different areas, right? So needing a little bit of computer science, needing quite a bit of statistics, needing data visualization and the ability to communicate with data is absolutely critical for somebody that's trying to inform and help policymakers make decisions. And so all of these tools are critical, and this is what you'll be gaining in the policy analytics degree. We have various modules and core modules in each of these various areas. Okay, so in addition to getting your skill set up to where it needs to be, you also need to get used to dealing with diverse sort of data sources, right? And so there's lots of talk in the media and kind of everywhere on the concept of big data, but we're also interested in small data and unstructured data and structured data and administrative data, survey data. So there's all sorts of types of data you're gonna need to be successful kind of in the modern sort of data-driven decision-making environment. And so one set of data that I think is quite important, it's becoming more and more important over time, is the idea of text as data, okay? And so we've obviously been, as humankind, been producing text for quite a long time now. Here we have the Sumerian tablets in 3500 BC, all the way up to the Gutenberg Bible, the printing press, and now, what do we have? We have really what's called the digital revolution. So we have just an inflood of text, or digital content more generally, but often text, that we can now look at and we can use and we can process to try and gain insights. And why would we care about this if we're policy analytics students, policy analysts in sort of government or even in businesses kind of informing government, is that governments produce lots and lots of text, right? And so we want to be able to use this sort of text to answer the questions we're interested in. And so that's really, really the drive behind this text as data module. So what are we going to do? So we really in the module, we're interested in what I call computer assisted, what other people call computer assisted methods in text analysis. Okay, and so given that this digital, influx of digital text that we have, it's just simply too much text often to be able to read. In a project that I'm working on looking at city press releases to look at local policy. We have about 75,000 press releases. I put that into a little handy app online, and if, like me, you believe everything you read online, it suggests that it's gonna take me about 2 years to read all this information if I sat down and read it. So clearly, we can't do that. So what we need to do is we need to turn to the computer as much as possible to help us in doing this. And that's what this course in this module is really focused on. Okay, how can we use the computer not to replace human beings, because there's still lots of human input that needs to go into the process, but how can we use these methods to assist and to complement sort of what we're already doing? So what will we cover actually in the module? Well, it turns out we'll cover a lot, but really we're going to go sort of through the whole pipeline from developing a research question around something that you hopefully are interested to collecting data online. So how do we collect data online? Often we scrape it, or so we're going to learn about web scraping, how to do, how to collect data, OCRing, so turning information that is in a PDF to something that we can actually use. So lots and lots of background on actual data collection, through to pre-processing, right? So what do we do once we have all this data, right? We need to get it in a format and get it in a, structured in a way such that we can use the computer to start to gain insight from that text and that data. We're going to be learning a lot of Python, right? So for this course, we're going to be using Python. Python's a very good language and commonly used language for lots of text analytic processing. And so that's going to be kind of our tool of choice. But once we've gotten this pre-processing and once we've figured out, okay, we have the data and how we need it to look, then we're going to go into the analysis. So often what we'll do next is this idea of classification, and we're going to spend lots of time on classification. So how do we classify the main topics or themes that are associated with a text, right? And it turns out we can, once we classify these topics or themes, we can use those classifications, right, to answer questions in typical sort of data analytic models that we're used to and sort of interested and using. And so we'll go into various sorts of classification methods, from supervised classification, where the human input is really essential to these sort of methods, to unsupervised methods, where we don't really know the categories that we're looking for or themes ahead of time, and we're going to use the machine to help us find kind of useful or salient categories, okay? And so that's really what we're going to do in the module, and that's what it's going to be. And so I've used this stuff to answer all sorts of questions that I'm interested in. So on climate change policy, on climate policy at the city level, even on religious sermons in the US context. And so I've used it to answer my research questions. I think the next question now is, what research question do you want to explore with these methods? And I hope you'll come and join us and realize that there's lots of potential and lots of opportunities to explore what you're interested in. Thank you.